All right, welcome to Mad Dash. This is episode 4 in this series where I go dashing on a Wednesday lunch and I talk about all the things that bothered me or got me upset, things I can rant on throughout the week while doing DoorDash. It is 11-11, make a wish.
11-11, make a wish.
I am activated in University Park. It says it's busy. South Miami was busy too, but I like to start off in University Park today because I live in South Miami, so I can always end the dash over here. And I've written a few things that happened to me, mainly on Friday night. Friday night was something to behold. Anyways, let's get our first order and go point by point. Okay. I didn't plan on talking about this, but I did. I've been getting BJ's Wholesale Club orders. This one said 5 items. It said 5 items when I accepted it, but yet it says 32 now. And check this out, the Zephyr Hills Natural Spring Waters, which is 40 packs of 1 pint of water. 10 and 10. A 40 pack and a 48 pack. I would need a fucking U-Haul truck to fit that in a car. I can't fit this order in my car. And I don't understand why DoorDash, they know what car I'm driving. So now I have to unassign this, and now I'm going to be at 94% because I'm at 95% completion rate. I really have to call DoorDash and let them know that if they're going to send me to BJ's, I could do 1, 2, 3 cases of water at most. They know I'm in a 2-door coupe. 10 cases. Do you know the volume of 10 cases of that? It's basically like delivering of 2 refrigerators. Like, you need a truck. And you need, like, 3 people. This is going to take you, like, 2 hours. So I'm going to unassign this, but this happened to me yesterday, and I started off the day bad, and now they want to loop me in there again, and I'm not doing it. I can't do it. It's not that I don't want to do it. I want to make 15. It was 1550 plus, and it's going to South Miami. Right? 5 items. Yeah, I could do that. Even if it was 5 cases of water, I mean, I could probably fit it in here. But 10? And then another 10? That's 20 cases of fucking water. I couldn't fit that in. I couldn't fit it even if I had bungee cables and I attached it to the roof of this car. I had to call DoorDash and be like, why are they even sending me this order? Like, I don't have a... Dude, a guy with a pickup truck would have a hard time fitting this in. You need like an F-150, F-250. All right, let me just unassign this shit and move on because... Boy, I didn't think I was going to get pissed because it's like manufactured. It's like, okay, now I got to do the mad dash. Well, if it doesn't happen right when it happens, you know, the fucking rant isn't going to be authentic. Well, you got authentic. All right, so I unassigned from that fucking BJ's order. They did the same thing to me yesterday. I did one of them. They gave me a BJ's order yesterday, and I did it. It was like a few items, and it was a case of water. Fine. I did it. Delivered it. Then they immediately sent me another one, and then it was 7 cases of water. Like, I don't know. It's like they have artificial intelligence that can predict all these things, but they don't know that there's no physical way I can carry... My car can hold that much... Mass. Anyways, and this is like the chat support person. You know, you don't have to call chat support to unassign. I'm like, yeah, I don't want it to affect my completion rate. because I shouldn't have gotten this order. You guys misled me. It's not 5 items, it's 32. There's a big difference between 5 and 32. Why am I getting these orders? So I just told her to fuck off, not in that many words, and I ended the chat and I unassigned from it. But now I'm at 94%, so. I'm done with BJ's, man. I mean, I'm done with it. I mean, how can they say 5 items and then you accept it and it says 32? That's a big difference, man. Jesus Christ, it's like a bulk load. Jesus Christ, I mean, why don't I just deliver a fucking living room set to this these people? In a fucking Kia. Oh my God, man. See, this is the kind of shit that makes me want to just go home and not even work the fucking lunch shift. Why are you sending me? I'm not even part of the large order program. I don't have a catering bag. Yet you want me to pick up 20 cases of water? Dude, that's like, you need an Amazon truck. 20 cases of water? Who's gonna carry all those cases from my fucking car to the fucking school? It was a school. It's like, God damn it. Whew. All right. Dude, and then in 1550 with the plus? Boy, that plus would have better been $200 or something like that. Because 20 cases of those, you know how much one of those 40 pack cases weighs? Almost like 20, 25. That's like a moving company. That's like you're moving. That you need a moving company and like 5 guys to fucking transfer that much weight. Like for $15? Like let's, even if it was $50, it's way too little money. It's way too little. A moving company wouldn't do that for under $200. Fuck it, man. Maybe $500. Dude, that is like a fucking room full of water cases. This is ridiculous, man. They need to have... I'm gonna call DoorDash and just bitch them out about this. I don't give a shit. I'm gonna talk to a person and I'm gonna bitch them out about how BJ's orders are being deceptive and they're not realistic.
All right, look, I actually went back, looked at the order and did the math. Went on the BJ's website, okay. Those 40 packs of water weigh 48 each. There was 10 of them. The 8-ounce version, which they also wanted 10 of, weigh 31 point something. Anyways. Then the juicy juice, they wanted 8 of these. That weighs 112 pounds. And then to top it off, two packs of this Ocean Spray cranberry that weighs 25 pounds. And I'm not even counting the tissue that they wanted. They wanted how many of those tissues? 2 boxes. Now these are huge boxes. Not counting the tissue boxes, 929 pounds, okay? So there's almost 1,000 pounds, okay? A ton is 2,000 pounds. This is almost half a ton of merchandise. And it's not even the weight. It's the bulk. 10 packs of that water will go from here to the ceiling. And there's not enough. It's basically a pallet full of shit. Anyways, let's just move on.
All right, I got my first normal order, a Pincrest Bakery for $6.50. Going not even that far away, going like 2 miles away. So, good, great. But it's like, I mean, who's gonna do that order? Who is equipped? Like, you literally, a truck is almost not enough. That's like, if you had a truck, you'd still have to take 2 trips. A flatbed truck. 10 cases of 40 waters? 16-ounce waters, by the way. Not small little cups of water. Big, huge, drippings of water, a 1 pint of water, 40 of them in a case. There's 20 of those. Like, who is equipped to deliver that unless you have a, who does DoorDash in a fucking van or a truck? That's orders, I'm gonna call them because that order's gonna get passed on and passed on until it gets, you know, it's gonna be undelivered. Who's gonna deliver that? Nobody is equipped to deliver that. You need a moving company. Fuck, man. But my problem is also like, how do they let DoorDash, how do they let customers order that much for a DoorDasher? Like, I understand if that came from BJ's, and there's BJ's has its own little crew of delivery guys or trucks. Like, if you order furniture or you need something delivered that's like, you know, a refrigerator or a kitchen stove or something, like, that's what you, you would need that kind of vehicle to deliver like a heavy item like that, to deliver that order. It was crazy. So, like, you know, they could bitch at me all they want, but I'm trying to help them. Like, no one's gonna be able to do this order. All right, let's deliver this Pinecrest Bakery. I'm fuming, man. Dude, you know how they carry that much water at BJ's? With those little wooden pallets and a forklift. You need a, like, what are they gonna do? Bring a forklift out to my fucking Kia? Oh my God. Let me relax and just hit this Pinecrest Bakery. Okay, I got the Pinecrest Bakery order in my car. Some pastelitos. I calm down. It's a normal sized order. Okay, it's like 2 bags. Jesus Christ. So, Friday nights in Miami. Let's talk about it. I don't know how it is in the cities where you live, but Friday night in Miami is a shit show. I don't know what it is. I know it's the first fucking night off that a lot of miserable fucks have after working their shitty little jobs all week. So I get it, you know? It's a release day. It's letting off some steam. It's going out. It's having fun. I get it. I just don't want to be a part of it anymore. I don't want to drive at night. I'll work Friday lunch and afternoon shift. But boy, when the sun goes down on Friday night in Miami, all the drama starts. All you could feel the tension in the streets. First thing you notice, and we'll go on a side little tangent on this one, is I notice police officers everywhere. Cops, blinking, flashing lights, people being pulled over, ambulances rushing, passing the red lights, people have to stop. Not worth it, man. If I get into an accident doing this, it'll be on a Friday night. So let's just take it off. Let's just take Friday night. Anyways, everybody's going out. There's less orders. You get none of the benefits of a weekend, but you get all the hassle and the low orders of people not being at home. You know what I'm saying? So, first thing I noticed was a motorcycle accident just on 107th Avenue and Miller. Just had to like go around it and flashing lights and ambulances, and it's just like, you know, I hope they're okay. I just don't want to be around that. Police officers everywhere. On the tangent, and I'll end with this tangent and then I'll deliver this. I witnessed a fucking robbery the other day at CVS a couple weeks ago. I didn't even know what was going on, but I saw, you know, you see on the news all these smash and grabs at Walgreens and shit like that, and they're saying that they're persecuting crimes over like $900. It has to be like over $900 worth of shit. I'm like, I'm sorry, dude. $900 worth of shit at a Walgreens or CVS, that's a lot of shit. To just go like, oh, well, just let them go. I get a shop and deliver at CVS. And as I'm walking up to the entrance, I see this fucking Cuban guy, and I could say he's a fucking Cuban guy because I'm a fucking Cuban guy, and this guy was a Cuban fucking asshole. Alright? Motherfucker. This guy has a red CVS cart holding onto it with both hands, filled with what appeared to be like Halloween decorations, like Halloween candy and decorations. And he was like running out of the CVS with the fucking little red cart, little red, you know, the little basket. And the lady was like casually following him out. And he was yelling to his buddy, oye, oye, arranca carro, arranca carro, arranca carro. It means turn on the car, turn on the car. And there was this dude, I guess his getaway guy, who was asleep at the wheel because he was not, the car was not running. And he's in this white truck. All right, hold on. I'm delivering this. All right, delivered that. Okay, I'm getting an 825 Papa John's. Going into South Miami. Let's just do South Miami then. Fuck it. They want me to go to South Miami that bad. The BJ's order was in South Miami too. It's like, okay, I'm going to South Miami, okay? I'm going to South Miami. Fuck, man. I hate when you, like, start off in a zone and they're constantly want to get you to the other zone. Okay, it's like, okay, dude, just tell me you want me to dash over there and I'll dash over there. So anyways, this robbery. So a dude's asleep at the wheel, finally turns on his thing. The guy goes, gets in the front seat and then drives off. I didn't realize what was going on until I spoke to the employees at CVS that it was a robbery or a theft or whatever you want to call it, a smash and grab. There's no smashing. It's just the guy just took a basket full of merchandise and walked out. I was in a perfect position to take a picture of the guy's license plate, but since like I didn't even put two and two together what was going on, I just thought the guy was in a hurry and maybe, you know, there was an emergency of some sort. You know, I didn't, my instinct isn't to think, oh, this guy's stealing a bunch of Halloween decorations from CVS. Like, I don't understand why you would risk robbing a store for some Halloween decorations and candy and stuff. Like, is it that? Is that expensive? So I walk in, I ask the lady, I go, did that guy just steal that? She's like, yeah. And she's like telling the other guy who works there, that's why I told you, you at this time, you never give him the red basket. I knew something was going on. I'm like, really? That doesn't seem like, I use the red baskets at night. I'm not planning to steal from CVS or Walgreens or wherever. Well, okay, so that was weird. Okay, I guess I have, but you see it on the news and stuff, smash and grabs are going up and stuff, but I saw it, right? And it wasn't like it was a CVS that was out of the way or in a weird area. This is smack dab in the middle of University Park. This is 87th Avenue and Coral Way. There's a lot of police traffic in that area. I don't know why you would risk going to jail or whatever for some Halloween merchandise, you know? I mean, shit. Anyways, let's pick up this Papa John's and then I'll continue my Friday night of hell. All right, I delivered that Papa John's to our favorite little apartment complex here near Dadeland Mall. So I unassigned from University Park and assigned here in South Miami and immediately got a Chick-fil-A for $12.50. So don't mind if I do. See that fucking guy? I'm glad I got that on video. Fucking guy. All right, Chick-fil-A all picked up. Ready to go. It's unusual to see a $12.50 order at this time. That's why I accepted it. Even though it's going into the Palmetto Bay zone. I'll probably activate down there. I activated down there yesterday, and I actually got a few good orders. Yesterday was another kind of a nightmare in general. Those BJ's orders really screwed my whole flow of the day. So I ended up driving to Homestead to see if I can drive during the rush hour traffic, because at 5 o'clock, all of these zones are, you're doing one order an hour. So I went to Homestead to avoid traffic. Did a few orders down there. Anyways, so while I drive down this, I guess we'll get into our little problem, Friday nights. Actually, let's say this. A lot of my problems on Friday night stemmed from this little box. Yeah, that's right. It's the adult Happy Meal. It's the cactus plant something or other meal. It comes with little toys. It's basically either it's basically a Big Mac value meal or a Chicken McNugget value meal, but it comes in a little exclusive little box. And this was the source of a lot of my drama last week. And I'll get into it. So the first night I heard of this little box, the first time this came into my universe was actually Thursday night. I was at the good McDonald's and I saw the advertisement for it in the drive-thru. Didn't think anything of it. Just like, oh, look, a little exclusive little box. I thought it was like a Travis Scott thing, you know, because he's the Cactus Jack or whatever, but whatever. I don't think it has to do with him. Anyways, I don't think Travis Scott is gonna be doing any collabs with McDonald's anytime soon after that fucking concert with like 50 people died. Anyways. So I go up to the guy, I shoot the shit, the good McDonald's, my boy. I go, hey, well, what's up? Nothing much, but whatever, bro, these fucking boxes, bro, they're like fucking people asking about them. And I'm like, oh yeah, what's the deal? He's like, it's like an adult Happy Meal, but we see it costs 10 bucks and we see them on eBay going for like 16 bucks. I'm like, oh, so people are reselling them. Oh, okay, cool. Good to know that. And how's it been? Do you guys have any right now? And he's like, yeah, we still got a few. I'm like, okay, cool. So it's not that hyped if you still got a few and it's Thursday night, right? So I didn't think anything of it. Later that night, I get an order from McDonald's, not that McDonald's, literally one down the street. And the drive-thru line is a little long, but it's a pretty good order. It was like a $9 McDonald's or something. It was like $9.50. And I saw that the drive-thru line was kind of moving. It was the McDonald's on 105th, 105 and Flagler, I believe. Anyways, so I bite the bullet, I stand in line. I notice when I'm halfway through the drive-thru that the customer that I'm picking up for ordered one of those little boxes. So I'm like, oh, okay. Well, you know, maybe they have them. You know, the last McDonald's I was just at like a half hour ago still had them. So why wouldn't this McDonald's still have them? Bottom line, I go to the thing. Hey, we can't do your order. I'm like, what? I'm like, what do you mean? I said I had a DoorDash. You said drive up. Oh, we don't have what the guy wanted. I'm like, hold on. This is just a fucking Big Mac meal. Let me call him, because can you give me the meal? Like, even if you don't have the stupid fucking toy? He's like, yeah, I can give you the meal. I'm like, so I call the customer. First fucking problem. Rude customers because of this fucking box. I call the guy after waiting for fucking 15 minutes in that goddamn drive-thru. I call the guy, go, hey man, they're out of the cactus box, but I could still get you the meal. Do you want the meal? And he's like, oh man, well then they shouldn't advertise what they don't have. Guy was rude to me. I'm like, listen, bro, I understand. I'm just calling you just in case you were ordering it for the meal, not for the toy.
Oh, well, no, whatever. I'll just cancel it. But now DoorDash is not going to give me my money back.
I'm like, hey, listen, bro, I'm sorry about that, blah, blah, blah. fuck you, motherfucker. You're not even gonna rate me because I'm unassigning this. Worst case scenario. Best case scenario, I'm calling fucking DoorDash support. They're unassigning it. It's not gonna affect my completion and I'm gonna get half pay. And it was like a $9.50 order, so you know, we're talking about like $4.50 or something, $4.25, half pay. So no harm done on my end. Like, great. But, and that's what ended up happening. I got paid half. But I'm like, all right. So this box is already fucking with me because these customers, they think they're big baller resell. Dude, if you're buying something for $10 and reselling it for $16 on eBay, I got news for you, bro. You're not making that much profit. Like, with fees and you have to go to the post office and shipping. Sorry, buddy. Like, you know, it's not like finding fucking trophy room Jordan 1s at fucking Marshall's for $50 and selling them for like thousands of dollars. Like, you're not a hustler, dude. You're fucking buying a cheap little fucking Happy Meal toy. Like, you know, like I used to collect the Love and Thunder ones. Whatever. You know, not exactly fucking finding the Marty McFly mags at Ross, are we? Anyways, I can make more profit selling this fucking Supreme hat. I mean, just, you know, if you want to resell, buy shit off Supreme, and that shit goes up infinitely more than fucking $10. You're going to make $16 with all of, it's just stupid. But I'm like, okay, this is going to be a problem. So I go back to the other McDonald's. The one that initially told me about it. And I said, hey man, people still ordering these things? He's like, no, we just sold out. So I'm like, okay, this is gonna be a problem for the rest of the week. I go, when is this promotion over? Nobody could tell me anything. What toys are available? What's the hardest one to get? I asked all the questions to the good McDonald's guy. He didn't know. He's like, whatever, fuck. He didn't know, whatever.
That probably looked cool.
Anyways, so I'm like, all right, mental note, I'm going to try to avoid McDonald's because I don't want to wait in the drive-thru and get paid half pay and have to cancel orders and deal with shitty customers that are trying to resell on a come-up on this stupid fucking box. Mental note. So, now fast forward, Friday night. I get my first McDonald's order. I'm not even gonna hide it. It's the shitty McDonald's, right? It's the shitty McDonald's in South Miami. But I double check the order that I have. He does not have the box. So I'm like, okay, good. I'm safe. I don't even give a fuck. But as I pull up to the drive-thru, just because I wanna be informed, I ask the guy, hey, do you guys have that box? The guy didn't even know what the fuck I was talking about. That's the other thing, is like, no one can tell you anything about this thing. It's like so exclusive and limited. Like, the guy just started working that night and he doesn't know. Like, I don't know, it's the first night I work when we have this thing. And so I'm like, all right, well, listen, just let me know if you have the box, because whatever. The guy doesn't respond to me. I'm at the drive-thru. So I pull up. Right, because I still have a DoorDash order. It's like, even if the guy doesn't know if he has the box or not, I still got to do my order, right? Pull up to the window, and this fucking kid, it's like a 17-year-old skinny little kid, and he starts giving me attitude. And I'm confused, because I'm like, I didn't do anything rude or say anything bad. I just asked him if they had the box. And blah, 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 the kid continues, and then I heard him under his breath call me a dumbass. This is a McDonald's employee. By the way, brand new, because that McDonald's, as I've stated in that last Mad Dash video, tune into the last 10 minutes of this video, and you'll see me talking about McDonald's employees and how that store specifically has to, like, hire new people constantly because it's a shit show. So I go, I heard him call me a dumbass under his breath, and I'm like, hey man, I'm just asking you about the box, man. You don't have to be rude. I was very courteous to the kid. And then the kid kind of blows up on me and goes, well, you don't have to be a dumbass. Duh.
I'm like, oh my God. So, and I feel like it wasn't me he was mad at. I think when you work that job, you deal with a lot of people. And who knows, it might have to be with the box, because everybody comes in there asking for the fucking box. So I was just the straw that broke the camel's back for this fucking kid. Dude, he actually leaned. I go, all right, listen, bro, I'm done with you. And I rolled up my window and I pulled up a little bit, but he could still see me from the window. He leans out of the window and threatens me physically. He says, I'll slap the shit out of you, old man, or some shit like that. And I'm like, what, did this kid really just say that? And he's leaning out of the window, out of the drive-thru window. He can't even reach me, so I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. And he's like baiting me, like egging me on, like, say I won't do it. Say I won't slap you. I'm like, dude, I don't got time for this motherfucker, dude. By the way, this kid weighed 70 pounds, wet and wearing boots. I could flick this fucking kid into the window and break his fucking neck, right? Like, he's just, this is Miami. This is Miami on a Friday night. Everybody's a tough guy. Everybody's a badass. Everybody's a gangster. Guess what, bro? I'll fucking eat your heart out, bro. I'll fucking murder you and eat your heart out. I'm not gonna do that. I'm just saying, this kid was not a tough guy. And he's gonna get his ass kicked. This is the kind of kid that goes to jail early in life and gets taught a lesson real quick. Punk kid. Anyways, so I pull up and I'm like, I can't believe this guy just threatened me. After I left, I got the fucking order. I left, I delivered it. It wasn't the box. But I'm like, okay, I need to avoid McDonald's, man, during this promotion shit. And I've been trying to avoid McDonald's. I did one last night, but most of the stores are out of them already. So this is like old news. Anyways, I was thinking, like, what if I would have just let that kid touch me, man? I mean, I wasn't going to do anything, because obviously I'm on the clock, and that's the last thing I need. DoorDasher fucking confronts McDonald's employee. All, you know, there's security cameras. Even as a customer, I probably would have ignored that kid. I'm 45 years old. I'm turning 45 years old. I don't have time to get into fights with shitty little thugs at McDonald's. I mean, he had to be, like, underage, too, because, you know, who would risk their job threatening a fucking customer or a DoorDasher? Like, he must really not need that job. Anyways, that was out of the way. Just a bunch of random shit happened that Friday that I can't even explain. Like, even driving back home, there was... Dude, it is fucking October. I saw a firework in the sky, like at 9 o'clock. Like, I don't know, left over from 4th of July. Like, it's not close enough to New Year's, and it's far enough from 4th of July where it's like, why is there fireworks in the sky? Is everybody here in this city fucking crazy? I just don't want to be around Miami on Friday nights. It's not worth it. And I do too well on Saturday and Sundays. At Friday, taking Friday night off, you'd be rested, you'd wake up tomorrow energized for starting early on a Saturday. Hey, look, this Saturday I made over $200 and I started early and I was dashing off and on. Dude, I think I can make, like, I can maybe break $250 or $300 if I wake up refreshed on a Saturday and I just hit the ground running and do as many zones as I can, and being picky, I could probably hit over 300 on a Saturday. I might try that. You know, maybe that'll be a video I do in the future. But not if I'm all stressed out and pissed off about all the shit that happens on Friday night. So basically, Friday nights, it's nice knowing you, Miami, but I'm not delivering to assholes, people that are driving erratically, people that are fucking speeding, people that are rude, people that are starting fights with you, traffic. It's just, and on top of that, since everybody's out, there's not enough DoorDash orders to go around, so you're not even gonna make enough money to warrant you know, spending the time. Friday night is gonna be a night that I'm gonna save whatever's on my gas tank and try to make the most out of that on a Saturday morning or afternoon. All right, that's my Friday night rant. If I miss something, I'll come back, but all right, I'm close to this lady's house already. See, that wasn't that long. Palmetto Bay is not that far from South Miami. It's just down US 1. Anyways, all right, let me deliver this and I'll come back.
All right,
delivered that Chick-fil-A, $12.50. Customer tip only $3 and base was $9.50.
I guess DoorDash knows nobody's driving this far for fucking, for $5. Like, I wouldn't have done this for $5 or $6. Like, fuck that. But another thing I've learned yesterday and doing peak pay last night at $2 a pop is I'm not going to see a $12.50 order tonight. I might, but things got scary last night, man. Things got scary. The lulls, the lack of orders coming through. Even the peak pay last night at 11:30 to 1:30 at the University Park, there was $2 peak pay. I had to accept everything. I had to. There was a $4.50 McDonald's that I accepted with a $2 peak pay. So that means guaranteed no tip. It wasn't going far, but even if it was, in those 2 hours, I've noticed, I learned from that time that was during the Hurricane Ian, when there was those peak pays, $3 peak pays. If you decline an order during a peak pay here in this market, you're not gonna see another order until after you would have delivered that. So you're not making that $4.50. Had I had declined that $4.50 McDonald's last night, I would have made $4.50 less that night. Luckily, right after I delivered it, it took me 8 minutes, by the way. And luckily, there was no line at that drive-thru at McDonald's. It was very dead. It was just, the whole city was dead last night. I got a $10.50 CAO bakery delivering a fucking, a cheesecake. That took me out of the zone, but it's like, I need that. I need that $10.50. That was a good order. And the tip out was $5 and the base pay was $5.50 with a $2 peak. So that means the base pay was $3.50. It's almost worth it to drive out of the zone for an order like that. At that time in my market, I'm not saying always, I guarantee you, man, because when I declined that Night Owl cookies that night of Hurricane Ian peak pay, I think it was the second night of Hurricane Ian, I don't know. I realized I made a mistake because I did not, too many people are in the queue. I'm not gonna get another order. And by the time I get another order, I would have delivered the one I just declined. That's just the way it's going. So luckily that was the only no tip order I did during peak last night. I got some pretty good orders. I got Wendy's for $8.50. I got another Wendy's later on for $9.50. You know, it was, in general, it was just okay. And then here's another thing. The peaks are from 11:30 to 1:30. At 1 o'clock, you're lucky. You're lucky if you get an order after 1 o'clock. Everything's dead. And there might be too many drivers out trying to get that last order in. So, all right. All right, so I'm driving back to South Miami. Should I dash here? No. You know what? Palmetto Bay was very... I had a couple orders that were good. But Palmetto Bay and Homestead yesterday, I learned my lesson, man. I tried to do it because I just wanted to make some money during the rush hour traffic. There's no rush hour traffic in Homestead because basically the only traffic in Homestead is people trying to go to the Keys. Like, there's nothing going down. So ultimately, I did an okay shift, but it's like I worked off and on all day yesterday, and I barely got to $100, and that's like squeezing everything out, you know, and I did some really questionable orders that I was really upset, and I declined. I declined some Wingstop and Little Caesars down here. It's just miserable down here in the weekdays when there's no peak. I used to love doing homestead, especially at night when there was peaks. I used to do really well. The consistency of the orders was one after another. But I learned my lesson, not doing these areas in the afternoon anymore for the foreseeable future, you know? But it was a good experiment. All right, let's drive back into South Miami. I got one more rant for you, one final rant. And then we'll call this vlog, this mad dash, we'll call it an end. But let's get our next order at least.
All right, I got my next order here in South Miami. I had to go the back route here. There used to be rooftop parking.
I'm talking, of course, of roasters and toasters. Right here, there's a Five Guys here too that I haven't gone to in a while.
There it is, Roasters and Toasters, New York Deli.
All right, my final rant for this mad dash has to do with the last order I did in my last video. Check it out right there. The last video, what was it? Anyways, it was the one that didn't really have a theme. And at the end of that video, if you go to the end of that video, I'm dropping off some spark plugs from the Advanced Auto Parts Store. And I got a story about that delivery. If you look at that video, I say that the order was $13.75, and much like that $12.50 Chick-fil-A, I'm not in the habit of declining $13, unless it's really out of the way, like Miami Beach, Wynwood, Hialeah. The map showed that it was delivering to Kendall. Palmetto Bay, Kendall, between Palmetto Bay and Kendall, kind of a country walk area, which is not far, but for $13.75, pretty close, you know, pretty doable, you know, and not insane. So, two things about that order. When I accepted it, it said it was 9 miles. When I saw the address, this is one of those address problems that DoorDash has with third parties. I've spoken to it about this before on that video where I had the double order and it was one of them was going way south, but DoorDash's algorithm thought it was going in the same direction as the other order. I think it was an ale house and a sushi maki. Forget that video. I'll see if I can find it. I forget what video that was. But anyways. So I realized the address was not a country walk address. If anything, that address was very much nearby. And the problem lays in the fact that I don't want to say the name of the place. So let's just call it an auto shop that dealt with tires. Let's call it Tires Galore. I was delivering to Tires Galore, but on the thing, it didn't say Tires Galore. It said a name of an LLC, possibly the company that owns it. And DoorDash had the address of that LLC, not the address of the tire store, Tires Galore. So I noticed it right away, and I said, oh, look at this. This is actually closer. This is actually, it wasn't even 5 miles away. So it was a $13.75 order. I'm actually glad they had the wrong address because they probably inflated the price point to deliver it. So you saw me in that video pick up those spark plugs and I was ready to deliver it. I didn't vlog after that, but now I'm gonna tell you what happened. Well, let me deliver this thing first. All right, I delivered that. $8.50. Not a bad order for a lunch shift with no peak, and it was right across the street, basically. Down the street. Okay, so, final rant. So I go into this, let's call it Tires Galore, and I go in there, I find it, it's the right address, the man comes out, and like it's expecting the DoorDash order. And I think to myself, this is what gets me in trouble, man, is that I think to help people. And sometimes you just need to keep your mouth shut and let people figure shit out on their own and just go about your business. And I hate doing that, man, because I'm trying to help you, man. I didn't need to, I figured it out. The address DoorDash had is not the same address that the fucking Google Maps had, okay? It happens all the time, and it's usually a problem with how they set up their account. So I go, should I tell this guy? Should I tell this guy? Yeah, I do. I go, hey, listen, here you go. Did you order the spark plugs? Yes, okay, all right. Hey, just FYI, you might want to check with whoever's setting up your DoorDash account, because the address was wrong on DoorDash. It wanted to send me to Country Walk.
Oh no, there's only one 127 Southwest 70 Dumb Avenue. I don't know what GPS you're using, but
fucking dumb motherfucker. I'm here, aren't I? Clearly, it's not my fault or my GPS's fault, because I am standing before you, you dumb fuck. I'm telling you, there's a problem that I didn't face, but in the future, another dumb fuck driver, like the kind of driver you think clearly I am, will make. So I'm like, hey, listen, man, I'm not saying it that I got the wrong address. I know where this is. I'm saying that another driver might drop this off in the wrong place and you'll be out of a thing.
Oh, but that's your problem.
He's still with this fucking it's your problem thing. I'm trying to tell him that it's not my fucking problem, because I'm standing in front of him. It's going to be your problem. Thank God you had me, a driver who is smart and who saw a discrepancy in two different addresses that were given to him. At the end of the day, I just said, all right, listen, man, whatever. I got it. We're good? We're good? He gave me the receipt? Yeah, okay. Have a nice day. But God help me. God fucking help me. So he ignored me. He just like, oh, this is just an idiot driver. I feel sorry for that guy, because the way he runs his tire business or his body shop, that's probably a reflection of how he treats his employees that work for him as mechanics. And I feel bad for those mechanics, man, because, you know, I like guys that work on cars. It interests me. I think they're smart people. And if they have a boss that is always condescending to them like that, always assuming that the idiot fucking employee or driver or whoever the fuck comes in contact with his dumb fuck ass is the one that has the problem. He's assuming and making an ass out of you and me. I feel sorry for the people that work for him, and I feel sorry, quite frankly, for his business. And I will say this, another thing. That address, the right address that I was at, that he worked in, was literally shared a parking lot. Not across the street, not in the same shopping center. Shared a parking lot with a different Advance Auto Parts. Now, could it be that Advance Auto Parts didn't have these generic spark plugs? Maybe, but I doubt it. Here's what I think really happened. Either he's too lazy to walk over to the auto parts store that's literally shares a parking lot with his body shop, or even worse. He's fixing a car, right? He is going around that. He could find an easy, quick solution to his problem, but I bet you he's using the service, because the Auto Advance part store that I went to was nowhere near this guy. It was like 5 miles. He's using the service so that he could bill the $13.75 I made. He's probably gonna bill that inflated to his customers. So I feel sorry for the people. I almost wanna say the name of the fucking real business, just so people don't fucking go there. This asshole who just is always right and always thinks the people are under him, are his underlings, are always the wrong people. I was trying to save you fucking time and money and future confusion and future misunderstanding to your business. But you know what? Fuck you. I hope the next driver delivers it and puts it in fucking Country Walk. And then it becomes, that's your problem. No, motherfucker. I'm trying to prevent it from being your problem the next time. You stupid son of a bitch. So I'll finish off and say this. Look, I've been all this time and I have not gotten an order. I'm right by BurgerFi. God help that miserable son of a bitch if I get an Advance Auto Parts going to his business again. Because I'll tell you what I'll do, because it was a leave at door. I'm going to hit the instructions on the map on DoorDash, and I'm going to go on purpose to the wrong fucking address. And I'm going to put the little fucking spark plugs or whatever the fuck I'm delivering on the doorstep of the fucking wrong address, a house in fucking Country Walk, 9 miles from this guy's business. I'm gonna take a picture and see you later, alligator. See you later. It's your problem. It's your problem. Yeah, he was a Hispanic motherfucker, and I can make fun of Hispanics because I am one. That fucking non-English speaking fuck. Dumb fuck. See you later, alligator. Now it's your problem. It's your problem, Speedy Gonzalez. I swear to God, if I get a fucking Advance Auto Parts delivering to that same address again, I'm gonna play the fool. And if DoorDash calls me and says, hey, this wasn't delivered, I'm sorry, check the GPS, check the geotag. I left it, the address that it is. Oh, looks like maybe there's a problem with the address. Not like I tried to warn anybody about that before. This is the problem with Miami people. And just like that 17-year-old kid at McDonald's who thought he was hot shit and wanted to prove that he was a badass or whatever to me for asking a simple question, this guy wasn't a young guy. This guy was older than me. This guy was in his 50s, 60s. This guy was a miserable human being. And I bet you he's scamming these customers by going the long way and spending money so that he can charge his fucking customers more money for the parts that he could have just literally walked across the parking lot to get. So I feel bad for anybody that has their car there, who's getting serviced by this guy. Hey, I made my $13.75 and I didn't have to drive 9 miles. It was right around the area. I didn't even leave the zone. I started getting orders right away. After that order, actually did a pretty good afternoon lunch that morning. That's what it was, the breakfast video. The breakfast fail and the switcheroo. Which, by the way, that switcheroo thing happened to me again at Taco Bell a couple nights ago. Yep, in the South Miami Taco Bell. I was driving home and I said, fuck it, it's busy here, fuck it, let's do one more order. And I got a Taco Bell for, I believe it was $2.75 or $3.50 or something, I forget. It was a low ball, it was like a no-tip Taco Bell. Delivering to UM, whatever. Immediately after accepting that, just like the last order, immediately, like I'm talking seconds, I'm talking like not even 10 seconds after I hit accept on the shitty order, I got a $6 plus, or a $6.50 or a $7.50 plus, delivering to the same area. Now you're trying to tell me that they're not hiding those good orders behind bad orders? I think that's happening. I think that's happening. Anyways, I'm going to go to BurgerFi and try to do a few more deliveries, but the vlog is over. Thanks for joining me on my ranting Wednesday lunch mad rant video. I hope you enjoyed it. I didn't think I was gonna be in the mood, but I guess that BJ's order really, you know, it's like I said, battery ran out, whatever, I don't know. Sometimes I think that it's better to rant when these things are happening to you instead of writing them down and waiting until a specific day, because I wasn't really upset today or in the mood to go on a rant or anything, but I guess that's my secret, Captain. I'm always angry. All right, take care.